Please enjoy hundreds of my video lectures on telecom and wireless. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Please also like my videos. Please share my channel with your friends and colleagues. Thank you.
Let us look at more types of power control. Reverse open loop power control. What is this? This is from mobile to base. Mobile receives signal from the base and makes a preliminary estimate of the path loss. Based on this estimate, mobile instructs its transmitter to adjust its power. The mobile receives strong signals, the path loss is obviously low, and therefore the mobile transmits signals at a lower power. If the mobile station receives weak signals, it shows the path loss is quite high, and therefore the mobile will transmit at a higher power. This is the principle of open loop power control. This process ensures that the received signal at the base station is constant irrespective of the distance of the mobile from the base station. The dynamic range of this power control is typically 85 dB. We saw reverse open loop power control. Let us now look at reverse closed loop power control. Base receives a signal from the mobile and measures its strength. Please note the base is the one which is receiving the signal from the mobile and measuring the strength. If the received signal is higher than a predetermined threshold, then the base station transmitter sends an advice to the mobile to lower its transmitting power. On the other hand, if the received signal is lower than the threshold, the base station transmitter sends an advice to the mobile to increase its transmitting power. This is reverse closed loop power control. Now, there are two variants in this reverse link closed loop power control. One is inner, which is fast, and the other one is outer and slow. Let us look at the inner loop. The base station estimates the received power transmitted by the mobile 800 times a second and compares it with a target value. An appropriate increment or decrement command is sent by the base station to the mobile within 2.5 milliseconds of the original transmission. A single power control bit, 1 for power down by 0.5 dB and 0 for power up by 0.5 dB, is inserted into the forward encoded data stream. Mobile responds by increasing or decreasing its output power as ordered. IS95 also uses the same approach. The dynamic range of this type of inner loop power control is plus or minus 24 dB. Okay, let us look at reverse link closed loop power control, which is an outer loop and slow. The base station controller gets involved in this outer loop. As power gets lower and lower, the base station controller starts receiving the frames in error from the mobile. That is, there is FER trouble. Base station controller then adjusts the threshold value of the BTS. Please note, in the outer loop, BSE is not involved in directly controlling the power of the mobile, but instead, BSE only adjusts the threshold value of the base station. And then, the inner loop controls the transmit power rapidly, as discussed earlier. The inner loop provides a rapid fine control and the outer loop provides a slow coarse control. Now, which is the culprit? Forward channel or reverse channel? As we said earlier, originally it was thought reverse power interference would be the main source of interference for CDMA networks. But, in reality, it is just the other way. It's actually the forward power which is the culprit. This makes effective forward power control very important. And that is why fast forward power control was introduced in CDMA 2000. What is fast forward link power control? This is done at 800 cycles. It is from base station to mobile station, uses reverse pilot channel. Let us now look at forward outer loop and forward inner loop. Forward outer loop. Please note the mobile receives a base station signal and measures the frame error rate. Earlier it was BSE measuring the frame error rate. Now the mobile is measuring frame error rate. If the detected frame error rate exceeds 1%, then the mobile sends a request to the base station to stop reducing its power. That is, mobile advises base station to stop reducing the base station's power. This adjustment process is slow, occurs every 20 milliseconds. The dynamic range of this type of power control is limited to only 6 dB in a 0.5 dB step because all the mobiles will be affected during this process. Therefore, the power control range is rather limited. This has provided a way for the mobile to communicate the forward link power control commands to the base station. Okay, let's now move on to the forward inner loop, which is quite fast. The mobile measures the received power from the base station. Please note, mobile is measuring the received power and compares it to a predetermined value every 1.25 milliseconds or 800 times per second. The mobile sends an appropriate increment or decrement command back to the base station immediately. The base station responds by increasing or decreasing its output power, that is, base station's output power as ordered. The reverse pilot channel is used for pilot bits and forward power control command bits. This is fast forward inner loop. Let's look at reverse link open loop power control with the help of some diagrams. Let us look at what exactly happens in a network scenario. Refer to the figure that is on your screen. It's animated. The reverse link open loop power control's underlying principle is that the transmission power of a mobile station is relative to its received power. In this, as we know, the mobile receives signal from base, maybe from various base stations, and makes an estimate of the required transmit power. This is used during mobile's access attempts. This loop determines the mobile's transmit power level for access probes based on total power received from various base stations. Updates the power level if the probe is unsuccessful. The mobile makes an access attempt using a particular power. The access was not successful, and then the mobile is advised to update its power in the second attempt. If that is also not successful, the third attempt is even more powerful, etc., etc. And the mobile waits for random time before transmitting the next access probe. That is based on CSMA, carrier sense multiple access. The open loop power control response is quite fast, especially for fast fading signal, that is rapid fading signal conditions. The dynamic range is typically plus or minus 30 dB. Now let us look at the new figure that's appearing on your screen. This figure shows open loop control in the reverse channel. Please note that there is an inner loop and also an outer loop in the reverse channel, which was not there in the forward channel. Now what are the drawbacks of reverse open loop power control? Reverse open loop power control mechanism assumes same exact path loss in both directions. Usually path losses are different for uplink and different for downlink. Please recall the principle of open loop power control. Principle is, transmission power of the mobile station is relative to its received power. The power is received in the downlink, whereas the transmission is in the uplink. And the basic assumption that the path loss will be same in both directions is quite flawed. Estimates are based on total power received, which includes signal from other base stations also. This also will give inaccurate estimates. These are the two drawbacks of reverse open loop power control. In this slide, let us look at reverse link closed loop power control, inner and outer. Refer to the block diagram, which is rather self-explanatory. We have seen the description of inner and outer loops already a few slides back. This loop begins action once access is given to the mobile. Tight power control is needed and inner loop is updated 800 times per second, that is every 1.25 milliseconds, and inner loop attempts to maintain EB by IT at the base station. Power control subchannel uses blank and burst techniques to transmit 1 or 0 to mobile to raise or lower its power level. Look at the loop now. The whole action begins by initializing EB by IT set point to a nominal value EB by IT at the base station. Now, EB by IT is measured on the power control channel every 1.25 milliseconds. After that, a decision making happens. Is the received EB by IT greater than the set point? If it is yes, then the mobile is ordered to downgrade its power by 1 dB. If EB by IT is not greater than the set point, then the mobile is ordered to power up by 1 dB. Therefore, a power up or a power down command is generated based on the measured EB by IT being greater than the set point or lesser than the set point. Okay, fine. After that, the number of commands, is it greater than the threshold or lesser than the threshold, decision is taken. If the number of commands has exceeded a specified threshold, let us say 16, Then a lock until power cycle message is sent to the mobile saying that we have attempted 16 times and the situation has not improved. Therefore, we are going to lock the mobile for a short duration. If the number of commands has not exceeded the threshold, let us say in this example 16, then it goes back and checks for a frame reception. Has one frame been received properly? If the answer is yes, then it's time for BSC to step in and calculate a new EB by IT set point and feed it to the BTS. This is known as the outer loop. Outer loop is starting from a correct frame being received, calculation of new EB by IT set point by the BSC and fed back to the BTS. This is outer loop. Okay, on the other hand, let's say the frame has not been received properly. Then the outer loop does not come into the picture and it is action as usual. It goes back to the inner loop starting point and the inner loop action starts all over again. So this is the reverse link closed loop power control, where inner and outer loops combine together and keep the mobile's power under control. In this slide, let's look at reverse closed loop power control, that is only the inner loop. We have seen the description through a flow chart in the previous slide, and here we'll attempt to make a diagrammatic representation. So the inner loop compensates for asymmetries between the forward and reverse paths. Base receives the signal from the mobile. Base measures the strength and compares this with the specified threshold or a set point. We have seen this in the previous slide. If the received signal is more than the set point, base orders the mobile to power down by sending a zero. If the received signal is less than the set point, base orders the mobile to power up by sending a one. In other words, based on the strength of reception, base orders the mobile to either power up or power down through appropriate command 0 or 1. Each command requests a 1 dB increment or 1 dB decrement of the mobile station's transmit power. This is transmitted 800 times per second and allows to compensate for the effects of fast fading. The figure illustrates a reverse closed loop power control, which is the outer loop. The figure is self-explanatory and you can recall the description of inner loop and outer loop in the flow chart two slides back. Please look at the animation and understand the situation. Please note that in the outer loop, BSC is the decision making authority. It receives frames and calculates the frame error rates. Please note, in the outer loop, the BSC merely advises the BTS to alter its set points. It does not command the mobile to either power up or power down at any point of time in the outer loop control. Let us now look at reverse closed loop power control, both inner and outer, with the help of diagrams. Look at the figure. Inner loop power control, the base station compares the measured EB by NT with the corresponding set point, and the mobile station will be ordered to decrease the transmission power if the measured EB by NT exceeds the set point. Otherwise, the mobile station will be ordered to increase the transmission power. The adjustment frequency is 800 cycles, that is every 1.25 milliseconds. This is inner loop power control. We have already seen the theory and this picture should be able to help you out in imagining what's happening. What is outer loop power control? Estimates EB by NT set point itself, reviews whether the set point itself is too low or too high based on the measured frame error rate. So in the inner loop, it is measuring the EB by NT and directly sending power control bits for increasing or decreasing. Whereas in the outer loop, base station controller measures the frame error rate and then adjust the set point in the base station. There is no power control bit sent directly to increase or decrease the power. The attempt is only to review the set points. The set point is increased if the FER is low, that is too many frames are received without errors and therefore the set point is too comfortable and lenient. The other scenario is set point is decreased if the FER is high, that is too many frames are received with errors and therefore the set point is too uncomfortable and too harsh. These are the two events that are possible. This review happens 50 times per second. EV by NT, what is this? Bit energy per density of interference power spectrum. This is similar to signal to noise ratio, and the reader is expected to brush up his fundamentals.
Hi guys, hope you have enjoyed this video. Before you leave this, please ensure that you are subscribing to this. Also, please do like these videos and share it amongst your friends and colleagues. There are plenty of other videos, and I hope you will be able to find time to browse through all these things. Thank you.